Hi, this is Anne from Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to import an MS Word document into your InDesign file and also map the styles over to your InDesign styles. All right, let's get started. Okay, so here I have my Word document. Actually, this is a Pages document because I don't have Word on my computer, but I can export to a Word document from Pages. And it kind of works the same way with styles. But anyway, your Word document needs to have styles in it. So this one, for example, is the heading. I've got this set up as body. I've got this set up as heading 2, body here, and then heading 2, and these are bullets. And I have the whole document set up that way. In InDesign, I've copied some of this stuff from the Pages document, pasted it in, and then made my own paragraph styles over here. So this one is H1, this is body. Then I've got H2 set up, and this one actually has a paragraph rule above it, you can see here. And then I've got bullets set up down here. So it's a really good idea to have your InDesign document already set up with paragraph styles. And also, your Pages or Word document also needs to have styles in it. Now I'm going to delete all this InDesign stuff because I'm going to be importing that whole document, not just a few paragraphs. So I'll come up here to File, Place. I'll navigate to my Word document, which is actually my Pages document saved as a Word document. I'll make sure Import Options is checked, and I'll open. Now all of this stuff, I'm going to leave the same, and then I'm going to come down here to Customize Style Import and Style Mapping. Now we can map our Word style to our InDesign style. Now Word puts a bunch of stuff in here that isn't being used, like normal. Since they have normal here, I'm going to go ahead and put that as body. But I also have body down here, and if they have the same name, which the InDesign style is also body, it'll automatically match them up. Heading 2, I don't have one called that, but I have H2. And then bullets is the same, hyperlink is not even there, and then the heading will want H1. Okay, and I think that's everything. And now I'll say okay, and then okay again. Now I've got the whole Word document formatted the way I want, or at least, you know, easy to change here in InDesign. Now mine looks pretty good, but I'm going to go ahead and select all with Command A or Control A. Then I'll come over here to the little flyout on paragraph styles and choose Clear Overrides. And as you can see, Word has tried to kind of overwrite my paragraph styles, and that will keep that from happening. Another couple things I've run into is if it comes in looking really weird, you'll want to go into each of your paragraph styles, double click it, and then come here to Keep Options and make sure Start Paragraph says anywhere on it. Another thing that may happen is that in your basic character formats, whatever your size is, your leading probably needs to be about 2 points higher. So here we have 12, and then this would be 14. If it's 0 over here, that can cause it to look really weird. So just change it to 2 points up from your size. Okay, we'll say okay. You might have to do that with all your paragraph styles. Now that I have a good start on this, I can, for example, change my bullet here. I don't like how the fill is all the way over there. I'll come in here to indents and spacing on my bullets paragraph style, and I'm just going to indent this a little more and then put the first line indent at a negative number. And that'll change all the bullets in the whole document at once. So you can go in here and make adjustments. I think I want this rule a little higher up. That's in H2. So I'll double click on H2 in my paragraph styles and then paragraph rules. And then for the offset, I'm going to increase this and just move all of those lines up a little more. Bringing in the styles from the Word document is a great starting point. I mean, there's still going to be tweaks to be made. For example, it brought in a return between every bullet. So I'm just going to highlight that all the way up to here, copy, and then do a find and replace with Command F or Control F. And that's coming in as a, I'm not sure what this is, but this is a paragraph. And I just want to get rid of that first thing. So I just have a paragraph there, and we'll change all. And that deleted that extra return in there. Now it looks like we have some other problems, but it's really easy to fix by just getting in paragraph styles and adjusting things. And that's it. All right, I hope this video was helpful for you. If you liked it and you want to see more videos like this, just click on the subscribe button and the little bell next to it. You'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.